Hey guys, welcome to another episode, well not episode, another tutorial of on 3DS Max here. This is part two of the kitchen island that we're working on. So the only thing we gotta do now, well first of all, each one of these gotta be unique. So we just detach. Just actually detach. This would be the left. Cupboard door. You know what? I'm just gonna do this. Otherwise, it's gonna be kind of weird. Because there's too many of them, and detach that. I'll rename it as it goes. This one just rename as well. This should be four. Right now, I gotta do the other side. Actually, that's pretty good. I actually like that in the corner there. Five. Six. Seven. Okay, this will be eight. Think I already detached these already. Yep, they're detached. Okay. All right, let's get a look at here. I guarantee it's the same thing. So, could do if you are following along. Up here to our original, our last model. Okay, I'm gonna leave this open. I'm gonna name this as knob so I can easily find it. Now I'll save as, I'll go back to here. Now I'll just go to import, merge, and then go to where I got the that scene made. It'll be right here. No, just find. Where the hell is it, Nawbat? Hold on a minute. Okay, I will just detach this for. No, I'm not gonna detach that. I'll just do this. I'll export it. As. Hold on, I gotta get rid of that. Okay, now I'll export it. Name this as knob. Okay, I'm not gonna save. Okay, now let's come up here to import, then import the what I just created. This will be right over here in the portable island folder knob. Okay, where is the knob here? Center to pivot. All right, let's get a look here. So there is one here and one here. They're like. Make it a little bit smaller. Okay, make a copy. Actually, I'm gonna actually get the. No, I can't do that. You see here. Okay, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually down here. The reason why I'm moving the pivot. Because I'm gonna actually gonna mirror it to the opposite side. That should be right dead center. So if I mirror this. Then push OK. Drag this down a little bit. Okay, same thing. All right, now I'm going to mirror this to the opposite side. Okay, we got our knobs on both sides now. Okay, we center that. find the center of this. We'll go there. I'll get rid of that after. Make sure okay, it looks all right. Okay, I'm just going to shrink this down just a little bit. That way it actually fits inside. I am not gonna resize those, they're fine where they are. The heck happened? I thought I made a copy of it. Did I not push the OK button? Okay, I did not. I'm just gonna do this because I can't see right. Okay, now I just smeared that to the other side. Okay, quick save. Okay. Okay, I can get rid of that edge loop now. I don't need that no more. All right, now start creating groups here. The reason why I'm doing the groups so I can actually be able to operate the opening of the cupboards. Now I got to here. Grab the pivot. Bring it all the way up to here at this spot. Okay, same thing with this side. Instead, we're going to go on this side. This pivot or gizmo, I think it's called. Try and make sure it's in the center. That should be good. Okay. Alright, now. So when I, try basically rotate this right here, they open up now. This side, okay, I forgot to do one other thing. I'm gonna actually hide section. Yeah, I kind of figured that this is the problem right here. I ain't gonna worry about it too much. I would like to create a divider for the cupboards. Oh, go, is there really a divider? No, this side I can't have a divider on it. Okay, only this side needs a divider. The other side don't need it because the sink is there. If I go this way, maybe I'll. Okay, I think that I gotta do now. That's better. All right, now I can unhide all. Last is number 8. Go to the back side. Change pivot. It's all set. Alrighty, so the drawers next. I thought I detached these already. Okay, detach. This would be 2. 3. I just leave that as fake drawer. Do they usually add knobs to the fake drawers? I need to find that out. That pretty much sums it up. That'd be a no. Although this one has a knob on it where the sink is. I'll just keep it there for looks. I think that's the way to go. Alright, so grab these knobs in this drawer here. What is this? Number. Okay, this would be this third drawer. And make sure this does not move. I'm gonna actually attach it to the this part right here. Well, actually, okay, so now that can't be moved because it's part of the island. So it's be drawer one. And this will be drawer two. Okay, so when they pull out, they actually work. And the cupboards, they open up too. Alright, so next thing we can create is this right here. There's an outlet right here on the side. So we're going to make the outlet, so we're going to save as, we'll go find a quick reference here to use. Did not say mall. It's hard to tell. Yeah, it looks like it is going to be like one of these plugs right here. So let's grab this, make a copy. only want to make a cop is basically grab this, save. Okay, so that's the outlet. So we'll come here on the side. So it looks like the outlet's going to be right here. Right here in the center. So let's just grab a plane here. Okay, kind of come on. Minimize that for a moment. Okay, this is 3.73. I'm gonna load the image here so I can see, keep basically look at the reference so I can model it out. Okay, now there's one or two ways of doing this. We can just create a box right here. Poly. So we're going to ring and then we're going to chamfer. I'll come up here and do this on this side though. About right there. Then add a few segments to round it out. Leo, no. Then let's drag this down. Alright, now we can just come up here. Pull this out. Make sure this goes all the way through. Now I'll make a copy of this. Actually, technically, I really don't need to make a copy of that at all. So I'm gonna do a quick save. Compound, propylene, imprint, start picking and do that. Alright, now collapse this down to edible poly. Select both sides. Just grab it like that, because you're gonna need this for the plug. Or actually outlet, I should say. Center outlet. Okay, so back to here. And then we'll bridge it. Add a few segments in the center here. And for this, we'll set both borders here, and we'll bridge that. A couple segments in the center, and it's good. Okay, but now we have to come up here, do a little inset. And then we'll chamfer this edge right here. Okay. Now we'll just put this in place. Now we can see it's actually looks like it's in part of the outlet. So now we just want to do one other thing here. Need to make the see through again, so put this at 35. So we gotta make these next. So create a box. Extrude that out. Create another box. Okay, edible poly on this one. Alright, so take these outlets, or the plug holes here, drag that down. Okay. We'll turn this on its side. Use these for the buttons. Then we create this shape with a spline. I want to make sure that it's actually straight. Okay, so we're going to take these and smooth it. Actually, I might just do a bezel here. Alright, then we'll create extrude. Drag this one down, put that right there like so. Alright, we have like a light right here, so we'll just create a cylinder right in the center here, and just go like so. Alright, now we gotta make sure these go all the way through to the end. Select all those. Alright, then we come up here. Save as again. Alright, now we come up here to create. Same thing, Probeline it's called. Imprint. Start selecting each one of these. Hold on a minute, actually. These right here, we actually want to make a copy of. These can be buttons. As for the rest, we can move them out of there. Alright, edible poly. Alright, select those faces there and we'll bridge them. Do the same with these. And we'll bridge that as well. Actually, I think we can select them all. This should do the same thing. Okay, I just noticed something here. This guy right here did not go through. All right, so all of them selected. We'll come up here to bridge, and we'll add one, about three segments. And these are gonna be buttons, so put them like so. Okay, drag that down. Okay, as for this spot right here, I should have kept this cylinder and I didn't do that. Okay, I'm gonna add a chamfer on this one. Alright, with all that done, grab these. And put this back into place. Okay, we got an outlet now. Save. Group outlet. Now I am going to add a backside, otherwise we'll be just seeing wood. I'm gonna just create it as black. So I'm just gonna grab a plane here and just drag across. This way it's simple and won't be really be noticeable. Now if we look, we see the inside easily. So I'm gonna hide the rest of the stuff here. Get rid of that. Alright, this has gotta be shrunk down by a lot. One minute, they not attached? I thought I attached that. Evidently I didn't. Okay, now it's attached. Okay, we'll just take this on its side. Might have to put that inside. Okay, the outlet's made. Let's see if it actually looks like about right size. Okay, so the next thing to make is the faucet. Looks like it's gonna be like a simple round. So let's look for a faucet here. Kind of almost looks like this one right here, but it's not. Might use that one at the top. Then again, this looks like it's the right one right here. Need to close some of these off. Actually might make the faucet and just come in here and put it together like I did with the outlet. So I'm gonna create a box up here. Okay, now I can just isolate this and start shaping this out. So edible poly, pull this out. Okay, ring, chamfer. Well, actually, not yet. Need to do something here first. I'm gonna shrink this down so. I'm gonna come up here and I'm gonna put a edge loop here in the center. Ring this and chamfer should no way ain't gonna work at all. Wireframe, I'll just select these like that. Then I'll chamfer it. See what happens if I just get rid of these. It shouldn't create that weird that shape. There you go, that's better. This is too wide though. I'm gonna shrink this down. About right there. Okay. Alright. I'll start doing insets. Extrude. Inset. Extrude. Once again, do another inset. This time a little bit smaller. Extrude that. Alright, so this is gonna be more round here, so we'll chamfer that. We'll also do this right here, and we'll chamfer these. Okay, I think this right here, this edge right here, is too sharp. Up here, we'll do another inset. And we'll grab that and do a chamfer there too. Okay. Now this side has to be done too, because this looks like it's kind of rounded down here. Let's create the handles next, or the knobs. So we'll come up here, actually we'll come up here to the top. Create one right here, like in the center. Okay, need to fix this. You know what? Don't have to have it perfect. Okay, I think that's good. I don't need that cap segment on there because I need to do a lot of extruding this. It's going to go up here. Okay, what I just did is I select one face, hold shift, and just basically highlight the one next to it, then click on it. That automatically selects all the faces in that one section all around. So okay, I'm gonna chamfer these. fight extrude there, then nerf extrude. This one will just go like this. Extrude. Chamfer here. Do the same thing with this spot. I mean, these edges. Whoops. I'm gonna chamfer that. Okay, so now I have to come up here. I'm gonna actually make a spear up on top. I'm not going to use a spear, but I'm going to use it to basically get the shape. Okay, now I'll just Nerd inset. Looks to me that it's not really coming out of here. It looks like it's basically kind of like screwed back on there. So what we could do with the spear here. On its side. Up to the top viewport here. Edible poly. Delete this section and delete that section. Can't really see what's over here. So I'm just going to guess. Actually, the way it looks like this right here is actually going to be now, this section here. Create a loop here. And put a chamfer in this one right here. This looks like it's going to be more. Oh, yeah, these. Need a champ for those as well. I'm also going to do that here on these. Okay, so making the end of it now. Oh yeah, that clipping thing, I gotta put that on. Alright, one more thing. Okay, that's done. Now I just bring it over here. Put that pivot point over here so I can watch what it's doing. Alright, so I'm gonna attach that. Actually, I'm just gonna create a group. Now I have to go here. Back to pivot. Make sure it's right in the center. So if I turn this, it should go like so. All right. Do a mirror. This making a. Okay, I thought it was making a reference. Now these actually might just put a smooth modifier on, at least to make this look better. This right here, it could be too hard. I'm actually going to hide these. Come up here, create a spleen, a spline. Go about right there. Now, if I come up here, select these vertices here. I'm going to go down here and go to where it shows fillet. Okay, that did not work. Okay, I'll try this instead. There we go. I'll be right back. Okay. Now I'm just going to keep this there for a reference. I can't lower these. Right, so if I can't do anything with that, I'll just do this instead. Okay, so come up to here. So now I want to create this right here. So I'll come up to cylinder. I actually want to find out where the center of this is at. Okay, I want to try something here. I want to actually grab this whole entire thing all around. And I'm going to just basically copy this. Now, the reason why I did this. If I'm correct, that this should do what I want it to do. Because you see here, this has like a. I don't know what you call them actually. Actually, hold on. Let me get rid of that shell. Might have to go a little, more rounded, more segments. So, let's see here. Go about 50 on here. Extrude. Chamfer. Actually, no, I'm gonna undo that. Chamfer these. Extrude. Chamfer. That looks better. All right, now border cap. Alright, so I can't inset that. Now I can just bring this down. Now, I know I don't look like that, but it's fine the way it looks. Okay, so that maybe that's higher. Okay, I'm gonna grab these edges, I'm gonna chamfer these. Alright, so this section now. Make this go loop all the way around and down. So I'm gonna save and come down here, extrude along spline and pick this. Alright, so now we gotta create some now I have to make this right here. now I can do this. I gotta get rid of that line, so I'm gonna save just in case it don't like what I'm gonna do. Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and delete that. Okay, now I'm going to create the inside of it now. Not really inside, but at least give it some depth. Okay, the faucet's done. Okay, we gotta get rid of some of these lines here. Close that off. Don't need that open. Okay, this is like definitely tough. Yeah, that's gonna be definitely be taller. I see a slight issue here. Let's see if I click this, put this at about 25, it should select everything on this side. Okay, just my vision. I thought maybe it was kind of off. In this case, I'll do the same thing on this side. Alright guys, I am going to end this here. If you guys liked the video, please hit the like button. If you guys want, you guys to subscribe as well. I appreciate the support. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in part 3.